Good morning. Praise the Lord. It's good to be in the Lord's house again today. I want to welcome you. And this is coming from Goson Church. We're located 4 miles south of Erskine, Minnesota, on Highway 59 and a half mile east on County Road 206. We're going to start out today with a song called Victory in Jesus. And it's good to have victory.
Jesus, my Savior, forever beside me, and He bought me with His redeeming blood. He loved me and I knew Him, and all my love is to Him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing
today. Praying the foot, Lord,
continue to pray for my mom for healing in her fractured pelvis.
Yeah.
still for my brother-in-law Keith. He's going in on Thursday. Yeah, the 13th now. They're going to do whatever they need to do with his heart.
Yeah. Well, praise the Lord. You know, aren't you glad God's in the healing process? And I've got a friend who is, his name is Kim. And his wife called me and he's having pain in his stomach and they don't know what's wrong. And they're trying and trying. They've gone through all kinds of tests and everything turns out good. But loves the Lord. Dearly loves the Lord. So, well, let's pray. Father, we thank you this morning that we could bring our requests to you today and know that you care and you've got the power to do something about it. Lord, we pray this morning for Keith that you would just touch him. Lord, that you would touch his heart and bring a healing. Lord, we just ask that you would glorify your name and do a miraculous work for him and also, Lord, for Julie's mom. Father, we ask you to just heal her pelvis. Heal that break. And Lord, that she can recover quickly. She's been through an awful lot. And we ask, Lord, you give her a miracle, but also, Lord, we pray that you would encourage her today. And Lord, that she can sense your presence right now today, that you are there and watching over her. Thank you, Jesus, that you care. We pray for my friend Ken that's sick today. We pray in Jesus' name that you would touch him. And Lord, that you would bring great healing to his body. Lord, you know what's going on. And we just come against this illness, whatever it is. And Lord, the doctors don't know what's causing his pain, but Lord, nothing catches you by surprise. And we ask you to be his healer and restore him. And Lord, that you would just give them peace today, that there'll be no fear, but they can rest in your healing power. Grant them a miracle. We pray, Lord, today for the people of Ukraine. Lord, as they're facing some terrible days if Russia uses their nuclear bombs, Lord, bring forth revival. Raise up, Lord, an army of Christians to pray and to seek your face. Lord, that there can be a great deliverance. We pray for our nation today that you would just bring about a revival. Lord, save this country, we pray, from destruction. All the bad stuff going on, we pray you would raise up godly people that will stand in the gap and drop back the darkness in Jesus' name. And we pray, Lord, for Israel. Lord, the whole world seems to be against them. Father God, we pray that you would bring about salvation to the hearts of many in that nation and put a guard around them. We thank you, Lord Jesus, today that we can trust you in all things. Be with all the sugar beet drivers and the people in the fields. Lord, keep them safe, awake, and alert during this harvest once again. And we'll give you the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. The scripture this morning is found in Proverbs. Okay. Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 through 10 says, "Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not on thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. Be not wise in thine own eyes. Fear the Lord, and depart from evil. It shall be health to thy navel, and marrow to thy bones. Honor the Lord with thy substance, with the first fruit of all thine increase. So shall thy barns be filled with plenty, and thy presses shall burst out with new wine. Honor the Lord with thy... No, that's... Okay. That's it. Yeah. Praise the Lord. Aren't you glad for the word?
Amen.
Aren't you glad for the word? Amen. Just think, maybe today Jesus is going to come. Wouldn't that be wonderful? Oh, praise the Lord. Just think, if he came today, by tonight the cars will all still be sitting out here. Tomorrow morning, they'd still be sitting here. Neighbor, people coming around said, I wonder why. Boy, they're having a long service. Oh, we'd be having a praise time, a hallelujah time in the presence of God. Jesus is coming again. Soon and very soon, we're going to see the King. Amen?
Amen.
Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we're going to see the King. No more crying there, we are going to see the King.
Okay, Psalm 100. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. To the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence to see. Know ye that the Lord is God. It is he that hath made us. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and bless his holy name. The Lord is good, and his mercy is everlasting, and his truth is truth. Hallelujah, glory, hallelujah. Hallelujah, glory, hallelujah. Hallelujah, glory, hallelujah. Hallelujah, glory, hallelujah. Let the temple be filled with His glory. Let the courts be filled with His praise. Let us worship the Lord in the holy of holies, Zion. Rejoicing again. Let this hour be filled with His power. Let our hearts be filled with His praise. Let us worship the Lord in the joy of His Spirit now and through all our days. His name is wonderful. His name is wonderful. His name is wonderful, Jesus the Lord. He is the mighty King, Master of everything. His name is wonderful, Jesus the Lord. He's the Good Shepherd, the Rock of all ages. Almighty God is He. Bow down before Him, love and adore Him. His name is wonderful, Jesus my Lord. Lord, Your name is wonderful. We praise You this morning. We thank You, Lord, that You are here in our midst, and that we can trust You with all things. We thank You, Lord, You've given us promises upon promise, that nothing should cause us to fear. But Lord, that we can just simply rejoice in Your presence, so we do today. Thank You, Lord, we can commit our hearts and our lives to You in all eternity. We bless You, Lord. We ask You just move upon us now and glorify Your name in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. The announcements for this week are, again, our telecast comes out on Tuesday morning at 10 o'clock, and then Wednesday night, Bible study at Sharon's at 6:30. And then again, next Sunday, our Sunday school at 9:30, and followed by worship at 11. Anything else that's coming up this week? So, all right, praise the Lord. You know, praise is something that should come out of our lips over and over. It should be such a natural thing to praise the Lord. And when Nathan said, I was shocked a few weeks ago, he told me this. He said a farmer came in, and this farmer, he's a big farmer, and his language isn't always the best. And And anyway, he was talking to some other people there, and he says, well, ask him, he's a man of God. And they said, you know, I'm just so thankful that people know this. And the things that come out of our mouth reveal who we are. And when we praise the Lord, not just with our lips, but with our heart and with our eyes, everything about us, it should be evident that we belong to the King. And what does your voice reveal? Share with you today, The Lord laid some things upon my heart that I trust are going to be an encouragement. Could you all use a little encouragement this week? And, you know, it's a good way to start out the week is having something to rejoice in. Well, let's pray. Father, we ask that you would do that today. Open up our hearts and our minds to the Word of God. And Lord, we just pray today that this will be a day when you would bring glory to your name, and that we would be encouraged to press on for Jesus Christ, in whose name we pray. Amen. Amen. The scripture today is found in the book of John, chapter 1. Book of John and chapter 1. And we don't have it up there, just let me punch the thing. And so, a very familiar scripture. John chapter 1. There's a lot of things going on in the world that are frightening. We've been hearing a lot of stuff on the news that we wonder what's going to go on next. Putin is threatening atomic warfare. There are a lot of people that are scared half to death. He is losing in Ukraine. He's being pushed back farther and farther. The very areas that he has claimed that now belongs to Russia are still under Ukraine control. And he is getting scared, he is getting really nervous, and the Bible warns us about this, that the bear of the north, now he's been wounded, it seems, and that a wounded bear is pretty dangerous. We don't know what's going to go on. And a lot of things are happening all around the world that are causing terrible fear. And so we wonder, okay, so what is coming next? And it's easy to meditate on these negative things that cause us fear and allow it to tear us apart, because fear affects everything in you. It affects all your muscles. It affects every part of your body. And people become sick from worry. And God's will for us is not that we worry, but that we live in peace, and the peace comes because we know the future, and our future is hid in Jesus Christ. We are not like the world. We who know Christ as our Savior, it is not that we don't think about it. It is not that we don't see what's going on. We just know the one who controls tomorrow. The one who controls our future. One of the things that is important to understand, remember the Bible tells us, God spoke to Abraham, and he said these words. He said, he who blesses you, I will bless, and he who curses you, I will curse. Israel is the heart of all prophecy. And we see the world is getting more and more convinced that Israel is in the wrong, and they're trying to tear it apart. The Muslim community wants Israel totally destroyed. They want to drive them into the sea, they've said, that they will never exist again. But God says, they're my people. Jerusalem is the city that's the heart of God. It's going to stay, but it's going to go through a terrible time. The Bible refers to it as a time of Jacob's trouble. And I'll tell you, it's pretty troubled right now. People have asked, well, why are all the bad things happening in America? The storms and everything. If you go back in history, every time our government has taken a stand against Israel, something happens almost immediately. It was right after President Bush had tried to divide the land of Israel and give the Arabs a state of Israel, so there'd be a two-state nation. He tried it, and the next day was when the towers fell. And also this happened again when Katrina hit. Just within a couple of days, Katrina hit after our president tried to divide Israel. And once again, President Biden was over and pressuring Israel to give up land to Jordan or to Lebanon and give them the gas wells that they have discovered and saying that really belongs to Lebanon. Give that to them. And our president was pressuring them. And then came the hurricane that hit Florida. And so anytime that you see our nation trying to divide Israel and going against what God says Israel is mine and Israel will stay complete. But you will notice that God's judgment will come. And as one person said, God is not actually sending the hurricanes. God is not sending the negative things. But what God is doing is he's withdrawing his protection. And then these things can come. Now, it kind of helps us to understand something. We need to be blessing and praying for Israel. Now, with this thing, this in mind, I want to take you into a very positive thing. And that positive is this. When God says, I will bless, what is the hope of the children of God? How can we lift our eyes and think, okay, we're going to still praise the Lord. We don't have to be afraid at night and lay there awake because wondering what's going to happen tomorrow. We've got something truly wonderful that's going to happen one of these tomorrows. And that is the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. And so we can still look forward to things. We can still rejoice. We can still see babies born and say, praise God. There's still a future for these little ones. And they may not be here in this world, but God is still God. No matter what people say, no matter what the media says, remember, God is still God. Now, in John chapter 1, it says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And the same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. In Him was life, and the life was the light of men. The light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. Well, we don't go past him. And in the beginning, you know, there have been people that have been trying for years and years to downplay the fact that God is the one who created the world. And they're trying to say it just happened. Well, we know better than that. God, all He had to do was speak, and the world came into existence. You know, one of the things that, you know, I am realizing more all the time, the older I get, the less I can do. Have you noticed that? You work twice as hard and do half as much. That is the problem with a body that is getting old. God has been around forever. Just think how old He is. And He's still just as powerful as the day that He looked down at this world that was without form and void, and He created life out of it. And all He had to do is say, let there be. And it was. The Bible says in Genesis chapter 1 that the world was out form and without form, and it was void. It was just like a heart without Christ. It's without form and void. It's an existence, but it has no purpose. And these people who have no purpose are the very ones that are trying to find some way of making it, making things better. We see this from some of the crazy things going on, even desperation to where boys or men are going through surgeries, trying to make themselves a woman, because maybe then I'll feel more, feel better. It doesn't work. Girls are going through surgeries trying to make themselves into a man, and they all become basically nothing. There is no satisfaction. There is no joy. You cannot improve on what God creates. You can't. But the world is trying. They're trying to do it their own way. And it leads to frustration. It leads to fear. It leads to heartache and pain. And finally, it ends up in suicide for many. God knows what He's doing. And a heart without God is a heart filled with fear. And in this world, we're seeing this fear. We look into Luke chapter 21. The Bible says, in the last days, man's heart shall fail for fear. After looking at after the things that are coming upon the face of the earth. There is no hope without Christ. But what do we have? What do you have? What do I have? We have the Word of God. The same Word that brought this world into existence is given to us to live by. To establish, to put this into our hearts. And God's Word, the Bible says, will never return void. It shall come to pass. That's why we pray in faith. And I hear from people, different ones, that say, I call you to ask for prayer because you believe God's Word. You have faith to believe. And when you pray, something happens. Now, that's a wonderful, wonderful testimony for this little church. That people know that when we gather together and we pray according to the Word, the Bible says where two or three are gathered together in the He is in the midst of them. God is here today. Aren't you glad for that? God is right here. We sang a little bit ago about let the temple be filled with God's glory. As we talked last week, we are the temple of the Holy Ghost. We're the temple of the Holy Spirit, the dwelling place of God. And because you are here, and you know Jesus Christ as your Savior, you have become the dwelling place of God. And because you are the dwelling place of God, when we gather together here, God is in His church. He's in our hearts. And if God is here, why are we afraid? God is here. The same God who created the heavens and the earth. He is still here. The Bible says where two or three agree as touching anything, it will be done. We may not be very big, but praise God for harmony. Don't you love harmony? I love harmony. Harmony sounds good. And when you bring a group of people, even though it's small, into harmony, great things happen. Because God's Word says, where two people, two or three, agree together in My name, to agree together, it and pray, it shall be done. Aren't you glad? That's a promise. It's a promise. It's written in the scripture. It will be done. That's why we pray in faith. Because we're praying according to what is written. If you've got a contract, and that contract has been signed by both parties, you expect the contract to be fulfilled, don't you? The people who've signed it. You go out and buy yourself a car. The person that had that owned that car before you, I'm talking about used cars because who can afford a new one? But you buy a car, and the person that owned it before, when they sell it to you, you hand them the money for that car. Now they sign off on the title. You take that title and you take it down to the DMV. And you hand them the card, and the person behind there sees the signature of the one who used to own that car. You do not fear of losing that car when you see that signature. You hand it over there, and you're expecting the title of that car to be transferred now to your name. You sign on the dotted line. And that vehicle now is yours. You drive it out. You are not worried about the title now because the title has been signed. And so because it's signed, you know, you have perfect faith. It is now your vehicle, right? God has signed on the dotted line his promises. Isn't that wonderful? Then why do we fear? God wrote it in his Bible. And he said, this is my contract with you. You have to rest in it. You have to believe in it. You have to receive it. And so in faith, we accept God's promises. So what are the promises that he has given to us in these troubled times? We are living in a time of terrible inflation. Right? Isn't this exciting? You go to a grocery store and it costs you twice as much as it did before. Wow. I went down to buy and set myself a pound of butter. $7 a pound. And that's in Walmart. That's a lot of money for a pound of butter. Oh, praise the Lord, I get to pay $7 for a pound of butter. No, I didn't see that. I put it back. I still got enough. But you look at the inflation, you see that, and they talk about this thing could go out of sight. And the devil tells you, you're not going to be able to make it. And you know, Ken, you're living in a tiny little trailer that's made for a lot warmer weather than what we've got in the wintertime. And you are wondering, what am I going to do when the weather gets cold, the snow begins to fall? What am I going to do? God worked it out better probably than you even dreamed. He says in his word, that contract that he signed with us, he signed it in his own blood. My God shall supply all of your need according to what? The economy? No. According to Congress? No. According to the president? No. According to my word in Christ Jesus. It's signed by God. And God took care of it. You've got a warm place to stay this winter.
Right. Amen.
And it's not in the trailer. God uses people, yes.
Yes.
He uses people. But he does it and he works it out. Because God loves you. Isn't that good? think of the needs we have. We pull up to the gas pump and we look at the price. Oh, but you know something? God still says, I'm going to take care of you. Look at our little church. People have said, how can a church that size keep going with a full-time pastor? Tell them it's God's church. It's not ours. We just get to come here and be with him. God's not broke. Things don't always come out on paper. Isn't that something? Have you ever gone to have your taxes done and have the one doing your taxes looking at all your figures and shaking their heads and how did that work? How can you live on that? Well, done pretty good. Because God is a God of miracles. And you're looking at the things that are going on in this world. If you look at it and you reason it out in your mind how you are going to survive, it brings fear. But you go into the Word of God, His promises, and those promises bring you peace. You go into Psalm 119. How many times does it say in Psalm 119, the Word, the Word, the Word? Those promises of God, you live in the promises of God. Because those promises will carry you through no matter what the storm is. You look back several years ago when that tsunami hit Indonesia. Was it Indonesia or Philippines?
Philippines.
That big tsunami. And it was right at Christmas time. The Muslims declared war on the Christians, you know. And they told them, you cannot celebrate Christmas here. If you want to celebrate Christmas, go up on top of the mountain and celebrate up there. So all the Christians went up on top of the mountain. And they were safe on the mountain. They were having a mountaintop experience. But down below, the tsunami washed clean many of those who were not Christians. God supernaturally protected his people, even though it made no sense to them. They were being persecuted. But the world was driving them to safety. There's a tsunami that is heading for the world today. But God is still saying, come up higher. There's a place of safety near to the heart of God. And so you can sit in the Word of God and feast your mind upon that Word. You can see why Satan always finds something for you to do when you should be reading your Bible. Have you noticed they can be in the dead of winter, you open up your Bible and as you begin to read, a fly will come and buzz your face. He should have been frozen a long time ago. But all kinds of things will come to interfere with your going into the Word. Satan knows that when God's people begin to move into the Word of God, reading it, storing it into their mind, the power of God will dwell within you. Back years ago when the Lord gave me the dream of heaven, you know, I've been reading the scripture for years by that time. But in that dream of heaven, all through the dream, it was like somebody standing behind me reading scriptures, one after another. The scriptures, it was just like they were being recited. These were scriptures I had read previously and stored them up in my brain. Even though I hadn't really memorized them, our brain is something else, I'll tell you. What you put into your brain, the Holy Spirit is able to touch that part of your brain and that scripture will come out at the right time. Scripture that you didn't memorize, but you tucked it there. If you never tuck the scriptures into your brain, how can the Holy Spirit bring them out? And so studying the Word of God is so vital to you. And when you do, at the right time, those scriptures will come back. And you remember, God said, God said, God said. God said in the time of illness, I am the Lord thy God who healeth thee. Oh, it's so good to lay in bed at night. What you're wondering, oh, I wonder what's wrong. Doesn't matter what's wrong, it's what's right that counts. And what's right is what God said. What do? We agree with God. Isn't that nice? Whatever God says, say, yes, Lord, I agree with you. Whatever the devil says, Satan, I don't agree with you at all. So bug out. I agree with God. And I'll tell you, when we start agreeing with God, all things are possible. There is nothing God cannot do. Have you noticed that? There is nothing God cannot do. We speak out the Word of God. And I know this sounds fanatical, and praise God, it is. Because I am fanatically in love with Jesus Christ. I know His Word is true. I know why God can do anything. And God has given us just tons of promises. And He's saying, believe it. Here's my promises. Take it. And you'll be rich, not in money. It doesn't mean you're going to have a big bank account. But you're going to have a riches in your heart greater than anything we can imagine. We will have joy unspeakable and full of glory. We will have peace that passes all understanding that will keep our hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. And in the midst of it all, we will find our love for the Lord Jesus Christ growing day by day. And as our love for Him grows, we're going to find ourselves praising our God. Praising Him not just with our voice, like the song said, but praising Him with our heart, praising with everything within us. And the peace that we have that dwells within us is the thing that people see. And when they see that peace, they desire to come into the place of safety where you live. All because the God who said in the beginning, there was the Word. In the beginning was the Word. And the Word was God, or with God, and the Word was God. He is His Word. Let's pray. Father, We thank you, Lord, this morning that you give me the wonderful privilege of being a cheerleader to the church. A cheerleader that can shout, God is real. God's word is real, and it shall come to pass. Believe it. Thank you, Lord. It's true. And Lord, help us, we pray, to keep preaching to ourselves. Every time we look in the mirror, God's word is real. Because God is real. And God lives in my heart. But Lord, we know that there are people watching today on television, on YouTube, that aren't totally convinced that your word is that powerful and that you are real. But the reason they have not been able to step into this positive belief that the word is real, they've been listening to the wrong voice. They're listening to an ungodly world that is trying to pull people from you. And they've never invited you to become Lord and Savior of their heart. Their body is not the temple of the Holy Spirit because they have not invited you in. And we pray right now, Lord Jesus, that wherever they are, wherever they sit, we ask right now that they will come to that beginning place and say, God, I'm scared. The world's falling apart all around me. I have no peace. I have no joy. God, I pray that you would save my soul. Jesus, would you come and live within me? Clean me out. Take all my sin away. Forgive me. I open my heart's door to you, Jesus. Come live within me. Make me the temple of the Holy Spirit, the dwelling place of God. I yield to you today. Come live in me and give me your peace. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Praise God. We're going to do a closing song here today. You know, if you want peace, you know, the closer you walk with God, the greater your peace, the greater your joy. You hold him off at arm's length, you never get anything. But when you draw close to him and say, God, just draw me to yourself, and he will come. Is it the invitation? He will always listen. Wondering why Jeremy's going to miss that. I told him I was going to take him out for dinner today, and I think he got too anxious and wanted to shorten up the service a little bit.
I am weak, but thou art strong. Jesus, keep me from all wrong. I'll be saved. my plea. Daily walking close to thee, let it be. Toil and snare. If I falter, Lord, who cares? Who with me my burden shares? None but thee, dear Lord, none but thee. Closer, walk with thee. Granted, Jesus, is my plea. Daily walking close to thee. Let it be. Life is old. Time for me will be no more. Guide me gently, safely home to thy kingdom shore, to thy shore. Is my plea. Daily walking close to thee. Let it be, dear Lord, let it be.
Let's stand together, shall we? Father, we thank you. We have Jesus. We have the word that promises, signed in the blood of Jesus Christ. And Lord, we pray that it shall be our prayer indeed that we walk every day a little closer. And any time something comes up that would cause us fear or doubt, Lord, help us to reach out and take the hand of the one who loves us more than anyone and the power to protect and provide, Jesus Christ. Give us, Lord, the faith of a little child that when he's in that, or she's in the arms of their mom, there's nothing to fear. Thank you, Lord. You're even bigger than that. And we just pray you just draw us all closer to you, to walk with you. Amen. Praise God from whom all praises flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen. Amen. God bless you.